once again, when we reached out to NSO Group, they put out a statement which we'll put on screen where they say that, look, this list has nothing to do with NSO. We don't know where it's come from. And in a sense, this is a defense that's also being recycled by governments like ours. What would you say to that?
With Amnesty International, we had access to a large list of 50,000 phone numbers that were selected as potential targets of surveillance in at least 10 countries around the world. We, through an analysis of that list and through a number of forensics analyses of phones that had been infected, we were able to show in a large way how extensive this spyware seems to be used in a number of countries around the world. Okay. So in India alone, we were able to verify the numbers of more than 40 journalists, everyone from journalists like Swati Chaturvedi and Rohini Singh, so who are contributors for The Wire, to local journalists, Jaspal Haran Singh in Punjab. So we also performed, like I said, 67 forensic analyses of phones that appeared in this list, and 37 of those revealed at least traces of spyware infection.
Sure. But Phineas, to my question, though, as to where you managed to get this list from, and is it, in fact, a list of potential NSO Pegasus targets? Because as you just probably heard as well, NSO is claiming that it's not.
We believe that our reporting and our analysis of this data seems to indicate that these numbers were at least potential targets of this spyware. And it's very important to note that this is not necessarily appearance on this list does not necessarily imply that the phone was compromised or was even targeted.
Okay. But at this stage, I assume that you're not keen to disclose how you access this list.
I'm afraid not.
Okay, but you stand by the fact that it is an NSO Pegasus list. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay.